Yes, student, can you all see my screen? Can everyone see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Everyone? Can you hear the voice of the video as well?
Yes.
So, welcome to online study, students. This is Ruksaar Firoz Khan. And today we are going to deal with history subject. And in that, we are going to deal with the chapter Janaparas and Mahajanaparas. So let's begin. The first topic in this chapter is Janapada. Now, what are Janaparas? You know, during the period of 1000 BC to 1600 BC, this period is considered to be the post-Vedic period. Now see, in the previous chapter, we have learned about the Vedic civilization and the Vedic period, right? So before Vedic, after Vedic period, post stands for after. So after Vedic period, that is from 1000 BC to 600 BC, that period is considered to be the Janaparas. It is in this period that the Janaparas came into existence. So during this period, the Janaparas came into existence. Now Janaparas, what were Janaparas? We'll see that. So Janaparas were the many small states that spread from today's Afghanistan, which is to the northwest of the Indian continent, to Bengal and Odisha in the east, and to Maharashtra in the south. So basically, what were Janaparas? These were small states, as you can see here. Yes. So now see, this is a small state. 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 All this together, these small states are known as Janaparas. This is one Janapada. This is another Janapada. This is just for an example I am showing you, that these are known as Janaparas. So all these small states were known as Janaparas. And these states had spread from Afghanistan to India. And where in India? To Bengal. That is to the east of India. Okay. So from Afghanistan to the Bengal and Odisha in the east. And some parts were in Maharashtra as well. Now the Janaparas called Ashmak occupied a part of today's Maharashtra. So in Maharashtra, the name of this Janapada was Ashmak. What was the name? You need to remember these words, okay? So in Maharashtra, it was known as Ashmak. The names of these Janaparas can be found in Sanskrit, Pali, and Ardha Magadhi literature. Now, you know, all these are the languages that were used in the ancient period. That was Sanskrit, Pali, and Ardha Magadhi. So, in these literatures, as you can see below in these images, these were some of the literatures. So, in these literatures, the name of these Janaparas were given. So, from that only we come to know that the Janapada of Maharashtra was named as Ashmak. One can also find information about them in the writings of Greek historians. Now, you know, students, there were many historians who visited India, right? So there were some historians from Greece and they were known as Greek historians. So they used to come to India and they used to write about India, like how are the living of the people, then what things did they see in India, what were something new apart from the other countries. So all these writings they used to write somewhere in their book. So in their writing also we come to know about the Janapadas. Some of the Janapadas were monarchies while others were republics. Now what is the meaning of monarchy? Yes, Pankhini, can you answer me? What is the meaning of monarchy?
Means monarchy means means kings.
Yes, the word monarchy is derived from the word monarch, and monarch means king. So when there was the rule of king, it was known as monarchy. Okay, so basically it means king. Very good, Pankhini. And others were republic. That means there were no king in the other Janapadas. So some of the Janapadas had kings. King used to rule them. Whereas some of the Janapadas were republics. That means there were no kings to rule them. They were independent on their own. They used to take their own decisions. They were not dependent on any of them. That was about the Janapadas. Now we will see what are Mahajanapadas. Now, some Janapadas had a Gana Parishad of senior citizens. Members of the Gana Parishad came together for discussions and made decisions regarding administrative issues. Like, see, if there are kings, so king used to take all the decisions without asking the common people, right? But when there is no king, the local people need to take decisions, right? So for some Janapadas where there were no kings, there used to be a Gana Parishad. Now, what is Gana Parishad? So, basically, this Gana Parishad was consisted of senior... Yes,
Gana Parishad means senior citizen.
No. It does not mean senior citizens, Pankhini. In Gana Parishad, senior citizens were there. Like Gana Parishad consisted of senior citizens. Okay. But basically, Gana Parishads were... Can you guess what were Gana Parishads by reading this line? Can you guess what was Gana Parishad?
Miss Gana means local peoples are...
Yes.
Local peoples. Gana means local peoples.
And Parishad means?
Parishad means I doesn't know, miss.
Tool ke niche choti tokri hai. Usme peele color ka hai packet. You don't know? Okay. No issues, but you are very much closer to that. So, Gana Parishad means a council of local people. Parishad is basically a council. When many people come together, that is known as Parishad. So, Gana Parishads were a council of people. So, which people basically? The senior citizens, as you can see here, the senior citizens. So, many senior citizens came together. So, when many senior citizens came together, that was known as Gana Parishads. Okay. But why, for what reason did they come together? What were the reason? Can you guess the reason? Yes. Yes, students are raising their hand.
Teacher, for discussing their problem issues.
Yes, very good. So these Gana Parishads came together for discussion. And what discussion? For the discussion of their issues. Whatever the administrative issues they had, they used to discuss that. Okay. And because of this, they did not needed a king as well. The place where these discussions took place was known as the Santhagar. Now, all these decisions, all these meetings used to take place at Santhagar. So, the place, the name of that place was known as Santhagar. Now, Gautam Buddha hailed from the Shakya Republic. Every Janapada had its own coinage. Now see, even during the time of Gautam Buddha, there were Mahajanapadas, and he hailed from the Shakya Mahajanapada. All right. Now every Janapadas had its own coinage. That means in different Janapadas, different type of coins were available. So the coinage was different for different Janapadas. Now see, today we live in India, right? Now in India, now for example, this is our India. All right. Now in the whole of India, we use single rupee. Like even in Jammu and Kashmir, we have rupees. Even in Tamil Nadu, we have rupees. So we have common coin in all of the India. But that time, every Janapada had different coins. Now some Janapadas gradually became stronger and expanded their geographical boundaries. Now first they were limited to small regions. Okay? But as the time passed on, they all started becoming more stronger. They started expanding their geographical boundaries. Such Janapadas came to be known as Mahajanapadas. Now see, Janapadas means small states. Now when these small states started expanding, okay, they started expanding their geographical boundaries. They started becoming more stronger. And when these started happening, so these were known as Mahajanapadas. From the literature of that period, it is clear that up to the 6th century BCE, 16 Mahajanapadas had acquired special importance. Now, when we read the literatures of Pali, Sanskrit, Ardha Maghadi, all these literatures, we come to know that up to the 6th century, that till 6th century BCE, 16 Mahajanapadas had acquired. How many Mahajanapadas? There were 16 Mahajanapadas who had acquired great importance. Like they became very important for everyone. Now some names are given here. That is Kosala, Vatsa, Avanti and Magadha. All these were the powerful Mahajanapadas of that period. Now in that, just a second, yes. Now in these Mahajanapadas, there was rise of the Magadha Empire. Now we saw Magadha is one of the Mahajanapadas that was very powerful. So now there was rise of that. Okay, just a second. Yes. Ajatshatru, the son of Bimbisara, continued with the policy of expansion of the Magadha Empire. Now see, Magadha Empire, we come to know that Magadha Empire was one of the most powerful Mahajanapadas in that period. So the son of Bimbisara, okay, he was the ruler of Magadha. So his son Ajatshatru, he started the policy of expansion. What is the policy of expansion? Can someone explain me the policy of expansion?
Miss, policy of expansion means my father was a king. So I have to handle the father's job. Like my father was king, so I want to become queen or queen king.
Okay, a very good try. Good. Yes, anyone else wants to try? No? Okay, I will explain you. Alright, now suppose you all stay at Goregaon, right? For example, I'm telling you, I don't know the exact place. For example, you all stay at Goregaon, okay? And you are the ruler of Goregaon region. Now, when you become the king Okay, and when you are the son of king, and now you are the king right now. So this is Goregaon. So you are the king of Goregaon. Now when you do the expansion policy, what you will do? You will extend your empire from Goregaon to the next stop, that is, say, Jageshwari. Then you also want to expand more. For example, you will go to Malad as well. So basically, you will become the king of Jageshwari also. And now you will become the king of Malad also. So this is known as the expansion policy. That is, you are expanding, you are going ahead. So not only to Jageshwari, suppose you are coming here as well. Now what is the before stop? For example, say Andheri. So you are here at Andheri as well. So what are you doing? You are expanding your empire from smaller region to the bigger region, to more bigger region. That is known as policy of expansion. So Bimbisara also followed the policy of expansion, but after Bimbisara, his son, that is Ajat Shatru, even he started with the policy of expansion. He successfully conquered many republics of the east. So he was moving towards the east. So he had conquered many of the republics in the east also. The kingdom of Magadha prospered during the reign of Ajat Shatru. So the Magadha kingdom that has prospered, that means it was flourishing during the reign of Ajat Shatru. Like, Ajat Shatru was a very good ruler, okay? He did good, great things for his region also. So the kingdom was also prospering. He had become a follower of Gautam Buddha. So even Ajat Shatru was the follower of Gautam Buddha. That is the principal. What happened? Yeah. So he also followed Gautam Buddha. And which religion did Gautam Buddha preach? Do you remember the religion that Gautam Buddha preached? Yes, anyone? In the previous lecture, we have learned about this. Gautam Buddha preached the religion of Buddhism. Do you remember or have you forgotten? Yes. So Gautam Buddha preached the religion Buddhism, and Ajat Shatru was the follower of Gautam Buddha. After the Mahaparinirvana of Gautam Buddha, it was during his reign that the first Buddhist council of Sangiti was held at Rajgriha. Now see, in the previous chapter, we have learned about the Mahaparinirvana of Gautam Buddha. Okay, he have achieved Mahaparinirvana, and after that, he had organized the first Buddhist council. We have learned about these as well. The first Buddhist council, and this first Buddhist council was held at which place? At Rajgriha. It was held at Rajgriha. So these Rajgriha, the first Buddhist council was held under the reign of Ajat Shatru. The foundation of the new capital, Pataligram of Magadha, was laid during Ajat Shatru's period. So the new capital was also laid, okay, during his period only, during the period of King Ajat Shatru. Now as you can see here, see, this is Magadha here. And this is Rajgriha. So here was the first Buddhist council and this is Magadha. Later it became famous as Pataliputra. Pataliputra was probably in the vicinity of today's Patna city. So, the new capital was the Pataliputra, and that is in the city of Patna today. A noteworthy successor of Ajat Shatru was the Magadha king Shishunag. So, after Ajat Shatru, who was the next ruler? The next ruler was Shishunag. He annexed the kingdoms of nearly the entire region of northern India, which came under the control of Magadha. Like, see, Ajat Shatru used to expand to the east. East is somewhere here. East is somewhere here. Okay. But this, the new king, that is Shishunal, he started expanding to the north. That means all this region of the north came under Magadha. That was how Magadha Empire took shape. So in this way, the Magadha Empire took shape as I have drawn here. First, it used to expand to the east. Then it went to the north-south. So in this way, it used to expand. See, this is India. So in this way, the whole Magadha Empire took shape. Now came the Nanda King of Magadha. The Nanda ruled the Magadha Empire between 364 BCE and 324 BCE. Now the new king came and the name of the king was the Nanda Kings. They had set up a good administrative system necessary to run the huge empire. So even this Nanda King was a very good administrator. That means he used to work for the welfare of the people, for the welfare of the city. So he was a very good emperor, and he used to run a very huge empire, as now we have seen. See, here is Pataliputra, okay? Here is Rajagriha, and before here was Magadha. Okay, now from here to the north to everywhere. Now this became a very huge empire. So he used to administer it in a very good manner. They had a huge four-column army of infantry, cavalry, chariots, and elephants. Now, student, I want to give you a small task. You need to find out the meaning of infantry, cavalry, chariots, and elephant. Elephants, so we already know. So this was the four column of army. Like, his army was divided into four. The first one was infantry. The second one was cavalry. And the third one was chariots, and the fourth one was elephants. So for elephants, I will explain you. The army of elephants means they used to fight by sitting on the back of elephants. They used elephants in chariots. You know what are chariots? Chariots are type of a vehicle, like for example bullock cart. So behind the bullock there are a small type of a chariot is made out of it. Okay, so there are horse chariot, there are bullock's chariot. So those are chariots. So when they used to fight using chariots, it was known as chariot army. Now you need to find out what is the meaning of
infantry and chariot.
Yes, tell me. Pankhini is telling something. Yes, Pankhini. Yes. Okay, so this is your homework. You need to find out the meaning of infantry and cavalry. We'll move ahead. The Nandas also introduced the system of standard weights and measures. Now, what do you mean by standard weight? Standard weight and measures, anyone? Yes, can anyone tell me? Yes. Sir, can you mute any of the students who can answer me?
I'm muting them, but they are not giving response.
Yes, I can hear some miss. Okay, I'll explain you what are standard weights. Now see, when you go to the grocery shop or any of the shop, and you tell me, and you tell that person, ki bhaiya, I want 1 kg of, for example, rice. Okay? So, he will keep some measures. Okay? He will keep one measure of 1 kg on his weighing machine and he will measure that rice and then he will give it to you. Okay. And after that, if you go to some other shop and you ask him, can you please check if this is 1 kg? He will keep this 1 kg of rice in his weighing machine and then he will weigh it and the weight will be same. So if you go to any part of the world, this 1 kg will be same everywhere. So that is known as standard weight. When the weight is same everywhere in the whole of the country, in the whole of the world. So this Nanda King had introduced the system of standard weight. Before, see, barter system used to go on. Like the people used to exchange things. But later on, what happened? The standard weight system started. And that was started by the King Nanda. I hope you all have understood the concept of standard weights.
Excuse me. Kate, I'm giving you permission when you are raising your hands. No, that time I'm giving you permission. But you are not unmuting yourself. If you want to give answer, unmute yourself when I'm giving you permission. Okay?
Thank you.
Yeah. So, King Dananand was the last king of the Nanda dynasty. By this time, the Magadha Empire had extended up to the Punjab in the west. Now see, they have started from here. This is Pataliputra. They started from here. They went to the north. Okay, they have occupied the whole north part. And now they are moving to the west part, that is Punjab. So now they have expanded their territory to the west also, west of Punjab. So till Punjab they have extended their territory. However, during Dhananand's reign, the ambitious youth Chandragupta Maurya, one Pataliputra, ended the Nanda regime and laid the foundation of the Maurya Empire. So what happened at the end? Now see, as we know, Dhananand was the last king. So during the Dhananand reign, the ambitious youth, Chandragupta Maurya, you will learn about him in the coming lectures. So the ambitious king, Chandragupta Maurya, he won the Pataliputra. Now there was a fight between Dhananand and Chandragupta. And in that war, Chandragupta Maurya had won. And the rule of the Nanda reign came to end. So here the Nanda Empire ended. And what came into being? The new foundation was laid of Maurya Empire. So all this territory was now in the hand of Maurya Empire. Now in the next chapter, we will read about the foreign invasions on the western and northwestern frontiers of India during the rise of the Maurya Empire. So here there was the end of Janapadas, Mahajanapadas and the Nanda region, and now the new region came into form, and that was Maurya Empire. That we will learn in the next chapter. So, did you all understand, students? Yes, so did you all understand?
Yes, miss.
Yes, do you have any doubt now?
No, miss.
Of the chapter.
No, miss.
No? So what we will do, we will quickly revise what we have learned and then we will end our lesson.
Okay, miss.
Just a second. We quickly revise all the slides. Pankini, do you want to say something? Pankini is raising her hand. Yes. So we have learned about the Janapadas. That Janapadas were the small... What were Janapadas? Janapadas were the small states that had spread from Janapadas were the small states that had spread from Afghanistan in the northwest to Bengal in the east and also to Maharashtra in the south. So you need to remember this. What were Janapadas? A direct question can come in your exam. What were Janapadas? So you need to answer this. Janapadas were a small states that had spread from Afghanistan to Bengal and to Maharashtra in the south. Then we have learned in Maharashtra. Okay, children, in which state do we live? In which state do we live?
Miss?
Yes.
We live.
Yes, Pankhini.
In Janapadas is called as Ashmak. The Ashmak is now called as Maharashtra.
No, I am asking you, in which state do we live in? Today we are living in which state?
Maharashtra.
Maharashtra, yes. Today we are living in the state of Maharashtra. And this Maharashtra was a Janapada. The name of this Janapada was Ashmak. So you need to remember this, okay? Ashmak was the name of the Janapada of Maharashtra. Alright? So that is one thing important. And one more thing is important. Some Janapadas were monarchies. So you need to remember this as well. Some Janapadas were monarchies and the others were the republics. Then comes the Mahajanapadas. What were Mahajanapadas? The Janapadas that had expanded. So you need to remember this. The Janapadas that became stronger and expanded their geographical boundaries. This was known as Mahajanapada. Alright. What is Mahajanapada? Tell me.
Yes, Miss, I am telling.
Yes, tell me what are Mahajanapadas?
Janapadas gradually became stronger and expanded the geographical boundaries. Such Janapadas came to be known as Mahajanapadas.
Yes, very good. So these Janapadas that became stronger and that had expanded their geographical boundaries, these Janapadas were known as Mahajanapada. So that is another important thing. Okay, and if I ask you, can you tell me the name of four more powerful Mahajanapadas? Can you name me? Yes.
Kolasam, Vasti, Avanti, Magda. And Magda was the very strong in Mahajanapadas.
Okay, very good. So the four names are Kosla, Vatsa, Avanti and Magda. These were the four powerful Mahajanapadas of that time. Then came the king. Who was the next king now? Magda Empire. Now came the rise of Magda Empire. And who was the king of Magda Empire? Do you know? Yes?
Miss Bimba. Yes? Bim.
Ajit Shatru. He was the son of Bimbisara. He continued the policy of expansion in the Magda Empire. So basically, who was the king? The name of the king was Ajatshatru. And he was the follower of? Do you know whose follower was Ajatshatru?
Santi Rajgriha.
No. Ajatshatru was the follower of which great personality?
Miss Buddha.
Very good. He was the follower of Gautam Buddha.
Yes. He was the follower.
Very good. very good, very good. He was a follower of Gautam Buddha. Now, after Ajatashatru, who was the next king?
Miss.
Yes.
The
After Ajatashatru, who was the next king?
Nanda. Nanda.
No, that came later on. Before him, there was. It was the king.
Magdha king.
No, Magdha king came later on. Before him, after Ajatashatru, the successor was. Very good. It was Shishunag. And after Shishunag, then came the Nanda kings. Okay. Now, Nanda kings were also very powerful. They have used these four column army. You need to find out, remember your homework, find out about infantry, cavalry. Then he have introduced the Western, standard weights and measures. And who was the last king of the Nanda dynasty? What was the name of the last king? The name of the last king of Nanda dynasty, anyone? Yes.
Yes.
Mogad. That's Mama Bokam. Yeah.
No, read the last line properly.
Danand. Danand. Danand.
Very good. It was King Dhananand. He was the last king of the Nanda dynasty. And then Nanda dynasty also came to an end. And which new empire was found? What was the name of new empire? The new empire was Maurya Empire. And who was the king of Maurya Empire? Who founded Maurya Empire? It was Chandragupta Maurya. He was the founder of the Maurya Empire. Because of him only, Nanda dynasty came to an end and Maurya Empire began. Yes. So, that was all from this session. I hope you all have understood it properly. Did you all understood it? Everyone? Did you all understand it?
Yes, miss.
So, do you have any doubt?
No.
No. Everyone, did you enjoy the lesson?
Yes.
Very good. So, that was all from today's session. You all were very cooperative and very understanding. You all answered me very well, students. So, very good. Keep it up. And now we will meet in the next lesson. So that's all. Now you know there is our YouTube channel on YouTube with the name BMC Education English Standard 6. This is the name of the YouTube channel. So please, students, go to YouTube, subscribe the channel, like it, and you can watch many videos of mostly all the subject. So make use of this great initiative taken under BMC. So thank you all. Thank you very much.